Alrighty, so begins the video for my playthrough of Quake Dwell, the add-ons community made. And this is for episode 2, which just came out. I'm playing version 2.1. A brief note before I start, I highly recommend if you play Quake with any modern source port, you really should set the texture mode to be linear instead of blurry for texture filtering. It really kind of ruins the art style with all this blurry filtering, and you don't really get to see all that chunky pixel art the way it was intended. So the easiest way to fix this, you can just open the console with the tilde key, which is above tab, and then type in GL underscore texture mode space, and then double quote GL nearest MIP map linear, all separated by underscores. So this command here. And so for the benefit of the stream, I'm playing with that texture mode enabled. And I've turned off particle effects because they're really rough on the video compression. But yeah, all that being said, I am ready to play Dwell Episode 2. I'm pretty excited for this. This seems like a very talented group of mappers and artists who made this. I think it adds some new enemies, new weapons. All kinds of interesting stuff. And Quake, despite being a more than 26-year-old game, more than 25 years old, the design is really good and it still holds up. The other nice thing about Quake with the modern source ports, I'm using Quake Spatial, which I prefer, is that really this can run on a potato computer. I mean, if you have any old laptop, any, whatever, as long as you have some kind of graphics, it'll play the original game fine and it will be able to play most of these kind of add-on campaigns. So, the story, there's not much story in the original Quake, but, for this, it says, "You have been torn from your restless slumber, your blood-caked chestplates still reeking of the charred remains of the hideous Shub-Niggurath, which was the boss of the original Quake game. It's impossible to tell how long it's been since your victory against her, since you fragged that abomination from the inside out. Everything was kind of a red blur. The runes you collected are all you have left. They thrum against your hip in idle readiness, their eldritch charms urging you forward, pulling you deeper." And we just play normal difficulty. Top of the Oh, interesting. Okay. Let's play episode 1, The Shifting Domain. The sands shift and ancient dread awakens deep below. I've already played this. This looks like it's episode 1. Episode 2, The Sunken City. A once great civilization now sunken deep below the earth to live again. Yeah, so if you're just starting out, I would recommend starting out with episode 1 and then 2. They are kind of atomic, they're separate from each other, and it's really designed to, I mean, you have to get all your weapons all over again, and yada yada. But I think the difficulty level will be probably slightly easier. Also a ray tracing RTX version of this game. Might be worth checking out as well. It's apparently pretty good. Yes.
Thank you.
projectiles can actually follow you around corners, so you have to time it very carefully. As good at this as I used to be. Normally I just try to fly through the level just as fast as I can. My reaction time's not as good as it used to be. Monster infighting, if they injure each other by accident, they'll attack each other. It happens inter-species, but not intra-species. So if there's a group of the same species of enemy, you can't really rely on fighting. But otherwise, it plays into the game design and resource management. Oh! That hurt. Thank you.
Huh.
Yeah, these levels are gorgeous. So the original Quake only had a 256 color palette, because with light and shadows and VGA graphics, that was the most they could have that actually had shadows. But with a modern limit removing source code, you can have a lot more vertices and a lot more colors, larger model sizes, and stuff. People are still making maps for this game. There's a website, quakeaddicted.net, and they have a tool called Quake Injector, which runs in Java. Just admiring the sunset. So this guy's cool. Okay, so it looks like I need to keep this down for us.
Ah!
backwards, usually you're more skilled just to avoid people.
Huh.
shield there. Worth a shot. They think of everything.
Thank you.
I hate those things. Oh man. Well, that was kind of the cheaty way of doing the level, the sequence break. Thank you.
Oh no! Ah!
Thank you. Huh. 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 Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Pick this up tomorrow.